We're here in Berlin at the Blockshow Europe, and we're here with Antoine Verbon. Do I pronounce it correct?
It's correct, yeah, Verdon in French.
Verdon, yes. He's from Proxeus. I just did a speak around with the panel, with the big guys, SAP and Oracle. How did it go, to your opinion?
Very well. We're the only IC on stage, but it was interesting to share views and see how, from our startup perspective, and we're going to revolutionize the enterprise world and how they are stepping in to incorporate blockchain in the enterprise processes.
Mm-hmm. What does Proxeus do, actually?
So Proxeus is a workflow manager. Mm-hmm. It came from the idea a few years ago that if you look at blockchain, it's about the same stage as the internet ecosystem 20 years ago. It's mm-hmm. it's very complicated to create blockchain applications. It's not very clear how, and we wanted to simplify that by, you know, when internet grew up, you had tools like Wordpress coming, which allowed anyone to put some blocks together and create applications. So we are doing the same for blockchain. We're a toolbox empowering anyone to come and move things together to build the blockchain use case they want to create.
And what kind of blockchain does it support? I mean, of course, the main blockchain is Ethereum at the moment.
Yeah, we've been mainly working with Ethereum, but we had one implementation for the Swiss company register with Hyperledger. At the end, I think the blockchain you use will not be so relevant in the future. It's going to be like if you use Outlook, you don't know if you're using an SMTP protocol for sending mails or POP3. I think it's going to be the same for blockchain. Hmm.
So it's actually all about applications, the decentralized apps?
Yeah, I think so. The last years were about creating the infrastructure necessary to build blockchain applications, and now it's about going one level up to the middleware or application layer and creating things that can actually be used by corporates.
And actually, your solution is also used, you mentioned, by the a few Swiss universities. Maybe you can tell something about that?
So we had one project with the University of Basel in Switzerland. Mm-hmm. They approached us because they have an issue, which is that they get a lot of phone calls from employers who want to verify if the diplomas mm-hmm. given to them by ex-students are real or if they are fakes. Mm-hmm. And currently, they are answering the phone and checking the records, but they wanted to provide an interface where employers can take the digital file sent to them by the students and drag and drop it onto an interface to verify it. So that's what we built.
And that works.
And that works very well. We built the whole thing in just 100 hours, so it was very quick. And it works. And I think the next step will be to have more universities using similar systems. And we'll see, I think, soon an ecosystem of trust being built around academia, where even on LinkedIn, you'll be able to connect at some point your crypto identity, and then you'll see a check mark appear if you're connected to your identity, you have a blockchain core certificate.
Wow. So that works good. And actually, does it work with the Hyperledger blockchain or this solution?
This specific solution we built was with the Ethereum blockchain.
So actually, your multi blockchain proof.
I mean, the Swiss company register project was implemented on Hyperledger, and there it has two parts. The first part is a smart contract connecting the different parties to improve the way they collaborate, allowing us to reduce the time it takes for incorporating a company from 10 days to just 1 hour, 37 minutes. So that's a Hyperledger smart contract. But if we go to the next step, it would be tokenizing the shares so that the shares of the companies created using blockchain can also be exchanged. And that would be on an ERC20 token. So using that, we would even have two blockchains in the same process and transaction.
Wow. Yeah, maybe you can tell something about the ICOs. You did an ICO. How many money did you raise, actually?
We raised $25 million during the ICO.
It was quite successful, actually.
It was, and it took place in February this year.
All right. And what did you do with the money?
Well, we are working very hard to build the application. Actually, we had built a first prototype already. We've been working on it for about 2 years, and now it's about scaling it up and making sure that we have a full team behind working on the project to make it happen and deliver everything we have described in the Proxeus white paper.
All right. So what are the next steps? More use cases, more tools to get these applications on these blockchains?
Yeah, these use cases we've been building is you can see them as a private beta of the platform, because we've taken customers from the outside that have built workflows that they need with our help. I think the next big shift for us will be to open up the platform so that anyone can come and build the applications without our help. So we're currently working towards that to have very good how-to videos and books to be ready to open the platform and allow anyone who has a blockchain ID to come and create a prototype within a couple of hours.
Very smart. It's just open source and then attracts customers in the end.
Yeah, I think it's going to be very exciting to see what cases will be built on Proxeus in the future.
Okay. Thank you very much. Do you have a personal motivation why you are active in this space? I mean, maybe you are a brilliant lawyer, or I don't know, maybe there was another industry, but why this industry? Why are you working in this industry?
Well, I started in the blockchain space in 2012. At the time, I was leading a fintech fund, and blockchain was very relevant because we thought it's going to change finance. And then I think the big shift for me was in 2014 with the Ethereum ICO and the arrival of smart contracts. Mm. There I understood that blockchain would not just change finance, but everything. And I think that's the motivation to see that there has been a big internet revolution. Mm. I think there will be a big blockchain revolution now at the same scale, changing every way the society and corporates are working together.
And what would you advise companies like SAP and Oracle? I mean, you were there with them on stage. What would you advise with startup mentality?
Well, I think it's going to be a challenge for them to keep up the pace with newcomers. We've seen in the last big digital revolutions, some of the companies, if you look at SAP or Microsoft, they have made it and went to the next stage, or IBM, but some others didn't. And it's going to be a challenge now for not just for those giants, but also for other companies to make sure that they can soon enough understand what the impact of blockchain will be on their business model in order to have some kind of advance towards the others. Because if you wait until 3 or 4 years that there are really live blockchain applications and you start then, you will have a whole learning curve and then you will be very late to the party.
Okay. So guys, start today, because otherwise you will be too late. We've seen it in the internet industry. So. Okay, thank you very much, Antoine, and have a nice day.
Thank you very much. Have a good day.